Welcome to another Species Spotlight. Kelsey here, and today we're going to be talking about the sausage tree. So I'm sure that if you've ever been to the garden, if you've been here on a field trip or just on your own, you've seen this tree. It's right at the entrance here, right next to the parking lot. And it's special because it's actually one of the few non-native trees that we have here in the garden. It's been grandfathered in, and it's actually native to Africa. It's not native to the Florida Keys. It doesn't grow here naturally. But it's a pretty cool tree, and there's a few fun facts that we're going to talk about today. So why is it called the sausage tree? Well, this is the fruit that it produces. It's a woody fruit, so it's really hard. When I knock on it, it makes like a sound like I'm knocking on a door. And it's really tough, right? So these fruits are actually, they grow on the pendulous stems. So all these really low hanging stems that you see right here, you can see some sausages growing over here. That's where they'll grow from. And they're actually food for elephants down in Africa. So elephants have a really strong mouth. They can bite into this woody fruit. And then inside of the fruit contains the seeds to this tree. So elephants will eat the fruit, they'll digest the fruit, and then they'll poop out the seeds somewhere else. And that's how the sausage tree gets spread. This is a pretty cool tree. As you can see, it's really big. They can grow up to 50 feet tall. So they're really huge. They're a slow growing species, and all these things are going to become important in just a little bit. It's a semi-evergreen tree. So that means that for most of the year, it has all its leaves and it's flowering and blooming. But for a small part of the year, during like the very cold months in the wintertime, it will lose its leaves, and that makes it semi-evergreen. This tree is an angiosperm. As you can see, it's flowering. So all of these right here are little flower buds. This one looks like it's going to open up here soon. There's a lot of them that have actually fallen to the ground. So I have an example right here. We have this really pretty dark red petals with the yellow stamen inside. And these guys are actually night blooming flowers. So this one, for example, might bloom at nighttime. It'll be open, nice and pretty, just like this. It attracts bats that are flying around at nighttime, which we do have here in the Florida Keys. They'll come and they'll pollinate the flowers. They'll come get some nectar and move on to the next flower. And then during the daytime, they'll drop off. So that's why we see a lot of flowers kind of scattered along the ground here. And another fun fact about these flowers, they contain a lot of nectar, so they're very strong smelling. They actually don't smell very good to humans typically. Most humans don't like the smell of the sausage tree flowers, but baboons, who also live in Africa, they love to eat these flowers because they contain lots of sweet nectar. The sausage fruit, so these ones down here, we're in the Florida Keys. This is not where they naturally grow, so the fruit maybe is a foot long or so. In Africa, it can grow to be about 2 feet long. So just imagine how big that is. Some of the uses that have, some medical uses that have come out of these fruits. So it has been used to treat multiple skin conditions. So acne on your face. It also treats eczema, which is just really kind of dry skin. It can treat fungal infections, ringworm, and even malaria. So it has a lot of medicinal purposes, this fruit does. And then the last thing I kind of want to talk about, so we mentioned how this tree is not native here, right? The sausage tree is from Africa, it's not from the Florida Keys. But does that mean it's invasive? So we know a lot about invasive species. We have iguanas down here, they're not from here. They eat lots of vegetation. That is native here. They kind of destroy our habitat. They eat vegetation that native species would otherwise be eating. So that's why they're an invasive species. They're causing harm to our environment. Is this tree invasive? Is it causing any harm? Some characteristics of an invasive species is that they reproduce quickly, they grow quickly, and again, they are causing harm to the environment. So let's think about that. So we've got this really big woody tree. Do you think that this tree grows very quickly? No, it takes a long time for this tree to get established, especially if it's going to grow all the way to 50 feet high in the air. Also, we talked about the woody sausage fruit, and we talked about how hard it is. There's not really a lot of things down here, no birds or anything like that, that could really crunch into this, eat that fruit, and spread its seeds. So this tree really isn't spreading a whole lot. It's pretty much just staying right here. And so that's why this would be an exotic species and not an invasive species. So a little bit of a difference there. Thanks for joining me this week, and I hope to see you guys next week for another Species Spotlight.